Hello, and welcome to this month's episode of As the Valve Moves. In these videos, we provide quick, practical insights to help you better understand valve actuation technology. We also want to educate those that may be new to this field so that you can do your job more confidently. I'm Rebecca Daniel, the Training Development Manager for Emerson Actuation Technologies. Today, we're talking about electric actuators with Kevin Frenneman. Kevin, can you please tell us a little bit about yourself?
Yeah, hi Rebecca. Thanks for the opportunity. I was born and grew up in South Africa. I started working in valve automation in the industry in about 2004. I immigrated to the USA in 2016 with my family. I was still doing valve automation with the same company. I then joined Emerson earlier this year as a subject matter expert for electric actuators.
Thank you. Well, let's start off our discussion, Kevin, talking about valve applications. When do you need an actuator for a valve application?
So an actuator is used when the force required to move the valve is more than what can be accomplished manually. They will also be used when a valve is in a remote or hard to reach location in a plant or especially on a pipeline. But they're most commonly used when the valve needs to be frequently moved to effectively control flow or a process.
So we've talked about the three different types of actuators based on their power source in a previous video. Today, I'd like to focus on electric actuators specifically. Why would a user want to use electric actuator?
So generally speaking, electric actuators are considered the most advanced type of automation for many applications today. Grid power is becoming available in more locations, and solar panels have also become more widely adopted. Plus, electric actuators reduce fugitive emissions, helping companies to meet their reduction in harmful emission goals.
I didn't know that. How does an electric actuator control a valve, though?
Okay, so the types of control for electric actuators are divided into three categories. You get open-close, which is also known as on-off or isolation. You get regulating, or referred to as modulating. And then positioning. This term often gets confused with modulating. Most electric actuators are controlled by a signal command from a power source, which is often a PLC or a DCS. This will tell the actuator how far and how often to move the valve based on programming or a process. They can also be operated at the valve via the interface. This operation will mainly be used for open, closed, and isolation only.
Can you tell me what the difference is between a mechanical intrusive actuator and a smart non-intrusive actuator? And does this difference affect how the actuator controls the valve?
It doesn't affect how it controls the valve, whether it's non-intrusive or intrusive. The most common difference between a non-intrusive smart actuator and an intrusive mechanical actuator is how the operator interacts with the actuator at the interface for programming and commissioning. An intrusive actuator will need to be opened up at the interface using tools such as a flathead screwdriver to adjust limits and torque settings, and by turning setting screws and setting mechanical switches. For a non-intrusive actuator, this is done by using the actuator control buttons on the actuator at the interface or using the manufacturer's software installed on a laptop or mobile device. This is done via Bluetooth or infrared communication. The other differences between the two are the technology and ability to store and download data logs and process information, which can be used at a later stage for valve or actuator maintenance, and also how the torque and limits are measured by the actuator.
So Kevin, you talked about actuator control earlier, with the different types being on-off, modulating, or positioning. Could you tell me more about that?
Sure, Rebecca, and that's an excellent question. All modulating or positioning electric actuators are controlled by a signal command from a power source such as a PLC or a DCS. On-off or open-closed refers to a control method that will send a signal or command to the actuator, which will ensure it to move to either the fully open or fully closed position. The valve will often stay in that position for long periods of time. This normally involves a hardwired 24-volt or 120-volt discrete signal. For positioning control, the signal will be analog signal, usually between 4 and 20 milliamps. This signal will send the valve to a certain percentage of open or closed, with a frequency that could be a few times a day or even a few times an hour. In this case, the valve is being used to control level or flow. This can also be done with a bus system, which is a digital or serial communication signal. And finally, modulating valves get the same commands as a positioning application, either via a digital or analog connection. But these signals are sent multiple times an hour and can even be several times a minute. These valves are typically used for more precise level or flow control, and actuators for these applications will have different specifications and components to accommodate the high frequency of operation. There is a lot of other stuff that will go into that, and we could probably do another session on the differences on the mechanical and electric side between the two.
Well, Kevin, it sounds like electric actuators have a lot more uses than many people may realize, and a lot of benefits. Kevin, thank you so much for taking the time to talk with us today. And to our video audience, thanks for watching. If you have any topics you would like us to talk about in the future videos, please leave them in the comments section below. We also have an email address listed in the description if you'd rather send your questions there. We'll see you in about a month for another episode of As the Valve Moves.
Thanks again for the opportunity, Rebecca. And if anyone has additional questions, our network of global sales partners will be happy to help you.